हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर ऑन दी पीवाई क्वेश्चंस रिलेटेड टू द सीएसआर नेट एंड द गेट एग्जामिनेशन। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द पार्ट टू ऑफ द इंटीग्रल क्वेश्चंस। वी विल सॉल्व ऑल दोज क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम द ईयर 2011 टू 2023 रिलेटेड टू दिस सीएसआर एग्जामिनेशंस। यू कैन सिंपली फॉलो माई यूट्यूब चैनल और यू कैन सिंपली स्कैन एंड ज्वाइन माई व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप। वट यू कैन फाउंड ऑन माई यूट्यूब चैनल, यू कैन सी देर इज अ प्ले लिस्ट सी एस आर यू जी सी नेट गेट एग्जामिनेशन वेर यू कैन फाइंड द पी वाई क्वेश्चन ऑन द कैलकुलेशन वेरिएशन पार्ट टू इंटीग्रल इक्वेशन। दिस इज द पार्ट वन ऑफ दिस सीरीज, पी वाई क्वेश्चन ऑन द आइगन्स वैल्यू, एल पी पी, पी वाई क्वेश्चन ऑन द एल पी पी ऑप्टिमाइजेशन एज वेल एज द पी वाई क्यू क्वेश्चन ऑन द स्टेटिस्टिक्स डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन, ऑल इन द प्ले लिस्ट सी एस आर नेट। Now, in this lecture, we will see how you can solve all those questions from the integral equations with the help of the shortcut trick. We will try to solve the 25 plus question in this part, while the previous 25 plus questions is available at the part 1 of the PY questions of integral equation. This is the series of this. Now, as we discussed, there are the three kind of the questions related to the integral equation. These questions we already discussed in our previous part, that is when the limits is start from the zero and it's a variable, while the second category is when the limits are my constants, and the third category is when one of the limit is constant but not zero and other is variable. This we already discussed that we can solve with the help of the Laplace transformation. This some of the question we already explained in the type 1, we can solve this with the help of the derivative. Now, what you can do whenever the limits are constant, you always try to convert this system into ax is equal to b. Make sure if this f of x is 0, then there is a equation of ax is equal to 0. Now, what you can do, I will firstly within a 1 minute, I can tell you the shortcut tricks, and then we can try to explain all those 25 plus questions within a simple time. Whenever there is a limits are constant a to b, you have to find this value of the k, that is a kernel. And then if you write, like if I say simply k of xy is my xy square plus xy, then you can say this is a function of the x, I call it f1. This is a function of y or t, this is my y, then it is f, this is a g1, then this is the f2, this is my g2. Once you are identified this, now how many fi are gi? This is a 2 cross 2. So we can convert the system here. This is my 2 cross 2 matrix. And these are the formula for this, but I will tell you how you can solve this b. As I already told, f of x is 0, then call as the homogeneous b. Now student may think that how you can remember this formula. I will tell you the shortcut tricks to remember that. For example, if your kxy is my xy square, for example, then you can simply firstly write f1 g1, and say another one is xy square is say cos x cos y plus sin x sin y. Then you can clearly say that in this case f1 g1, f2 g2, because there are the two terms. F1 is a function of the x, f2 is a function of the x, g1 is a function of the y, and g2 is a function of the y. Same for here, but is f1 is x, this is the y. Now you have to convert this into ax is b. Also this is ax is equal to b, where a is my, how many, these are the two, so f a is my 1 cross 1. Here is f1 and g2, so a will be my 2 cross 2. Then you can find this is, if it is a 2 cross 2, then you can find the matrix as here. Fine. So how you can find, this is a very very simple tricks for you. Whatever the limit is given to you, 1 1, the first number is represent for the g, other number is represent for the f, so it's a g1 f1, g1 second number is for the f, g2 f1, and g2 f2, and we know f1 g1, you can find the limit, you can find the limit, and so on. Another thing is g1 of y and f1 of y, all are there. In this case it will be g1 of y, f1 of y. This is the value of the a. Okay, now how you can find the value of the b? Again, this is g1 f of x. What is the f of x is of here, this is my f of x, this is one thing. If you have that, if you have the two, then there are the two b1 and b2. One is corresponding to the g1, second is corresponding to g2 is there. That's a simple. Then you can find the value of the a as 1 minus lambda a1 minus alpha 1 2 minus 2 1 1 minus 2 2. This is for the 2 cross 2. If it is a 1 cross 1, then you can simply write this as alpha 1. Now, based on this trick, we can solve this question in a very simple manner. Let's start with this one. Look at that. The limits are constant. So this approach is applicable. It is a homogeneous. So we can convert this system into AX is 0. Fine. When the system of the AX is 0 has a non-trivial solution. When determinant is a 0. So it means your target is to find the here. So what is the alpha 1 1? I can write this k x comma t as ex into e of t. So f1 is a function of the x. This is ex. This is et. So what is the alpha 1 1? Limit says my 0 to 1. This is f1 into g1. So this is e raised to power t and e raised to power t. So what is the limit of this? E square minus 1 over 2. So what is the my a? A is 1 minus lambda times alpha 1 1. So the determinant of this is a 0. So what is the answer of this? Lambda will be 2 over e square minus 1 is the right answer. We will solve that. 25 questions are there. You will learn in a very simple manner. Now here, what is the f1? Is cos square f. What is the g1? There is no function of that e, so we call it as a 1. So there is a 1 cross 1. And here is a non-zero, so it is a b also. So what is the a? You can written as this is the value of this. Now we can find the value of the alpha 1 1. Limit says my 0 to pi. This is the f1 of t cos square and this is 1. And we all know it's a 0 by using the orthogonal property. The answer is pi by 2. So we can substitute here. So what is the answer of this? Lambda is my, this is my lambda. So 1 minus 2 over pi. This is pi by 2 x. What is the b is? Right hand side 0 to pi g 1 into fx. Fx is my 1. So clearly says that left hand side is 0x. Right hand side is non-zero. So is it possible? No. So what is the meaning of that? It has no solution. Look at this one. Now here your f1 will be x. g1 will be y square. Because this is my kernel. Now it is again a 1 cross 1. You can write this as a non-homogeneous here. So what is the alpha 1 1? Limit is my 0 to 1 f1 g1. So it is a y cube. What is the integration of the y cube? 1 by 4. So you can write the system as 1 minus lambda times of this x. What is the right hand side is? Limit is from my 1 to 0 g1 and f. This is fy dy. So what is the answer of this? Can you find the answer of this? What is the lambda? Here you can see this is the value of 1. So lambda is my 1. So what is that? This is 3 by 4x is 1 to 0 y square fy dy. So what is the value of the x? 4 by 3 y square fy dy. That's the right answer. Since this is non-homogeneous, so the final answer will be, you can add them as a f of x. So you can see this is the right answer of the problem. Again, you can see this is the function and the limits are my constants. So what is my f1 is x, f2 is a function of the t, g1 is always with a function with respect to this integration. Now there is, you can see ax is equal to b. So what is the alpha 1 1? Limits are from minus 1 to plus 1. You can see t and e raised to power t. I can tell you the shortcut tricks how you can integrate by parts. Whenever there is a polynomial, this is the polynomial, you can differentiate this until it becomes a 0. Similarly, until it becomes a 0. Now you can multiply this, you can multiply this. The first one is a plus, second one is a minus. So what is the integration of this? T e raised to power t minus e raised to power t 1 to minus 1. So what is, I can written as t minus 1 of this from minus 1 to plus 1. 1 will be 0. So plus 2 e raised to power t. So what is the answer of the a? 1 minus lambda is my e by 2. This into 2 times of e 1. E of minus 1. So e of minus 1 is my here. Into x. Right hand side is my this. G is my here. Into f of t of dt. Now you can see. This value is my 0x. So that means minus 1 to 1 e raised to power t f of t of dt is my 0. Now you have to check the options. There exists a continuous function f from this open interval this. What is the meaning of that? So since there is an open interval, so f of t is greater than 0. E raised to power t is always be greater than 0. So the product of them can never be 0. The first option is cancelled out. Similarly, second option, it is the open interval. Second option, again say f of t is my less than 0. So and e of t can never be 0. F of t can never be 0. Second option is also cancelled out. Look at the third option. If f of x is here, you can substitute this value. E raised to power t. What is that? This is e raised to power minus of t. 1 minus 3 of t square. So what is the integration of this? So t minus t cube over 3. So it clearly says that it's my 0. It's a right answer. It's a part C. You can start from here also. So if you substitute f of this, so it will be t plus cube plus 5 over minus 1 to 1. Integration of this is 0. 0, 0. So right answer is my fourth also. So the C and the D are my right answers. Okay, now you can see. Now again the limits are constant. But there is no need to write as a kernel because you have to find the solutions. Look at the derivatives are there. You can differentiate this with respect to the x. So what is that? It is a partial derivative of u with respect to x plus 1 to 0. What is the derivative of the mod of x? So x minus over this into u of s. Right hand side is a. So which is the correct option? You can see here. This is my correct option. This is cancelled out. Now, in order to take the second derivative, what you can do in the second derivative? You can see this value, this mod value will be 1 if x minus s is greater than 0 and minus 1 when this number is less than 0. I can break this number as from 0 to x when 0 to x, that is whenever s is less than of the 1. So what is the answer of this? When it is a less than of the 1, you will get as a plus 1 or minus 1. You can easily see this value is my whenever x is less than 1, so it's a plus of us ds plus lambda times from x to 1, it's a minus of us ds is equal to a. Now you can again differentiate this with respect to x here plus. What is the derivative? Partial derivative, it's a 0. But if you take as upper limit, you as a u of x plus of this partial derivative 0. If you take 1 as this is 0, so minus u of x of minus 1. So is a 0. So what is the answer of this? It's a lambda times ux and this is the u double dash. So right answer is my a is the right answer. Now again here. You can see now you can see f1 is my s, f2 is my g1 is my t square, f2 is my s square, g2 is my t. But there is no need to solve like this way because you already have a solution given to you. So once it's already a solution, you can simplify this is with respect to t. So s is my constant outside, t square y of t plus s square. 2 is a constant, so it's a t of yt. That's over. Now what you can do, you can start from the options. Look at that. If I just simply take this coefficient of the s square here, it means the integration of this, what will be the answer? It's a 2 times, so it must be 25. So let's check off this one. What is the y of t? It's a 60 times plus 50 times of the t square. Now you can see 60 t square. Answer is cube, that's a 1 by 3 plus 50 times cube, so that's a 4 from the limit 0 to 1. You can see it can never be a 25 because it's a 20, it's a 4, so it's a cancel out. If I start from here, if I substitute this, t times minus is outside, 30 times t plus 40 times t square. So it's what is the answer is 30 t square, integration is my here, plus 40 times cube, integration will be 4 over minus. So it's a 10, it's a 20. So it's minus of 20 and multiply by 2 is minus 40. You can see it's a minus 40 is the right answer. We can check we can check about the minus 30 will be there or not. So I can clear this side for you. We can check about this part also. So 0 to 1, t square minus is outside, 30 of t plus 40 of t square. So what is that? It's a cube. Integration will be my 4 plus 40, it's integration 4 divided by 5, it's a minus. So it's a 15 over 2 plus 8, so it's a 31 over 2 minus. If you multiply by 2, it will be give you minus 31s. And this is the 1 plus s also be there. So the right answer is minus 30s. You can see this is the right answer of this problem. Rest will be cancelled out because there is a part B question. Okay, look at this one. Again, the limits are constant. So what is my f1? What is the g1? F1 is 3x minus 2. G is my t. This is a function of the x. This is a function of y. So ax, it's a homogeneous. So ax will be a 0. What is the alpha 1? 1. This is 3t minus 2 into of 2. So what is the answer is 3t square. So it's a 1 by 3. 2t square, it's a 1 by 2. Answer is 0. So it means, what is the meaning of that? 3t square. T square is a t cube by 3. It's a 1 by 3. And it is my 2t. It's a t square by 2. It's a 0. So a has a... So what is the alpha? What is the a? 1 minus alpha 1, 1. What is the eigenvalues? Here. So 1 minus this of 0. So a is my 1. If you substitute here, 1x is 0. What is the meaning of that? It has a unique solution. Unique means that is a trivial solution. So what is the meaning of that? Once it's a trivial solution, it means it has no characteristics, equations or the numbers. So what is that? There is a no characteristics number. So right answer is D is my correct answer. Okay, again, it is a homogeneous system. So AX is my 0. What is my F1? What is my G1? F1 is ES, G1 is my here. Now you can find the alpha 1, 1. Limits is my 0 to 1. E raised to power 2t. So e raised to power 2 minus 1. So what is my a? Lambda times e square minus 1 over 2. X is my 0. What is the x is? Because they are written the x, where x is limit 0 to 1 g. What is the g is my here? Because this is a function of the a, so you can written as a y. If you have written as a x is equal to b, then on this side b, it will be the function of the fx, homogeneous. Now you can see. You can see this is my x. So what is the answer of this? So ax is equal to 0 has a unique solution, or you can say trivial solution when? Trivial solution when determinant of a is non-zero. It has a non-trivial solution when? When determinant of a is 0. Now you can see that. Non-trivial solution, determinant of a is 0. So when it will be 0? When lambda will be 2 over this. But they said x is equal to 0 is the trivial solution, non-trivial. Let's cancel out. Trivial solution when determinant of a is non-zero. So when determinant of a non-zero, it means lambda is a non. And what will happen? X is equal to 0 is the right answer. X is my here. So this is the right answer. Non-trivial solutions for determinant of a is for all lambdas non-zero. No. Why? Because for the non-trivial solution, this x must non equal to 0. Non-trivial solution. But that condition is only here. This is my x is non-zero. Non-trivial solution when determinant of a 0. That means lambda is my 2 upon e minus 1. But x will be my non-zero. So right answer is my here. So b and d are my correct options. Okay, again the limits are constant. Now you can see, if I open this bracket, what is my, this is my cos x, g1 cos, I can written as a cos of a minus b, cos a cos b, sorry, cos a cos b is a sine a sine b. Fine. Now it's a non-homogeneous, so we have to write ax is equal to b. So what you can do? Alpha 1, 1. Limits are from minus 1 to 1. G1, F1, that's my cos square pi by 2. So once we know here, how you can solve this, because it's orthogonal property, it's a 1. What is the alpha 1 to g1 f2? Because of the orthogonal property, this answer is 0. What is the alpha 2 1 g2 f1? Again, because of the orthogonal property, from minus 1 to plus 1 is a 0. Alpha 2 to g2 f2, it is my minus 1 to 1 sine square pi x, because sine and cosine are similar, so it is a 1. So what is my a? This is 1 minus lambda times of 1, 0, 0, 1 minus of this. So what is the answer of this? 1 minus 0, x. What is the right hand side is? Minus 1 to 1, g1, cos pi t into fx. So this is minus 1 to 1, cos pi t fx. And for the second case, minus 1 to 1, g2, sin pi t, or pi x or gx, and f of t here. Now you can see here, unique solution. What is the meaning of the unique solution is? When it will be the unique solution, when determinant is a non-zero. So lambda is not equal to 1. When this is my a, this is my b. What is the rank of the a when lambda is not equal to 1? 2. So what is the rank of a condition b? Whatever the value of the x are there, once the rank is my here 2, rank of a condition b is also be the 2, definitely. So what is the meaning of that? It will give you a unique solution because it is same. So the first option is correct. No solution when lambda is not equal to 1. Lambda is not equal to 1, the rank of this is again 2. Rank of this is 2, but here it is always be a 2. But when it will be no solution, when they are not equal but they are equal, so it means this is a cancel out. Third case, when lambda is equal to 1, what will happen if lambda is 1? Then the rank of a, these are the zeros. When it is a no solution, when it has some non-zero value, so what is the x? So what is the x? If I substitute here, and this is the cos of pi x, so I can take the differentiation. Cos is minus sine and 0 of minus cos of pi x. This is the plus sign, this is the minus sign. Clearly says that what is the rank of a condition b? What is the rank of the a condition b? Rank of a condition b is my 1. It's a 2 because both are there. So both are not equal to. So we can say 1 is a not equal to. What is the meaning of that? It's a no solution. Lambda is equal to 1. When lambda is 1, rank of a is my 0. When f of x is 1, so what is the integration from minus 1 to 1 cos pi x? It's a 0. What is the integration of the sine pi x? Again, it's a 0. So rank of a is rank of a condition b. Both are same but not equal to 2. What is the meaning of that? It has infinite many solutions. So that's a simple procedure of that. Now, again for this, we can write as f1, g1, f2, g2. F1 for here, 2x. G1 is t. 4x square, this is my 1. Now what is the alpha 1 1? Limit is from 0 to 1, f1, g1. So 2 of t square, answer is 2 by 3. Alpha 1 2, 1 2 is, that's a g1, f2. G1, f2 is integration of 4 cube. So answer is 1. Alpha 2 1, this one, 2 and 1, integration of 2x, it's my 1. Alpha of 2 2, this one, so it is again 4 t square, that's a 4 by 3. So what is your a? 1 minus 2 by 3, minus this, and 1 minus 4 by 3 of this x. What is the right hand side? Because it is a homogeneous, so right hand side is my 0, because f of x is my 0. Now how you can see that? You can when it will be have a non-trivial, so you can find the determinant of this. So what is the determinant of this? 1 minus 2 by 3, 1 minus 4 by 3, minus of here. This is the way, this is the solution, you can easily capture that. Now what is the answer of this? You can simplify that. This is 1 minus 6 by 3 plus 8 by 9 minus of this. So what is that? 1 minus 6 by 3, that's a 2. It is minus 1 by 9 of this. So that means I can take minus 1 by 9 as a common. So it is my 2 plus 18 minus 9. So clearly says that what is the root of this? What are my roots of this? So root is my lambda 1 and lambda 2, both are non-equal. So what is the meaning of that? Once it is a non-equal, so this condition satisfied, this is cancelled out. Now, what is that? These are the corresponding eigenfunctions. So what is the property of the eigenfunctions? Orthogonal. What is the property is that when lambda 1 is not equal to lambda 2, then the corresponding function of this lambda 1, corresponding function of the lambda 2 are my orthogonal. Once is orthogonal, what is the integration of this limit? Is always be a 0. Orthogonal, that's inner product is 0. So this is there, this is cancelled. So the right answer is A and D are my correct answers. Okay, again the limits are my constants. I can written as cos of A plus B. F1, G1, F2, G2. F1 is cos A, cos B. What is that? This is minus sin A, sin. This is the simple procedure of that. Cos of cos A, cos B minus sin A, sin. So how you can do that? So you can find this alpha 1 1, alpha 1 2, alpha 2 1, alpha 2 2. So limits are from I 0 to pi. Cos square. Always remember orthogonal properties of the cos function. This is my pi by 2. Always remember if it is a pi by 2 cos square, then it is a pi by 4. That's a half of this. Whatever is this, half of this. And whenever it's a cos and sine, it is 0. Similarly, if it is a sine square, then pi by 2. 1, 2, that is of this. G1, F2 is a cos and sine, 0. 2, 1, 2, 1, sine and cos, 0. 2, 2, this one, that is a minus sine square. Sine square is my, sorry, it's a pi by 2. Sine square is minus pi by 2. Fine. Now you can find the values of the A. What is that determinant? 1 minus lambda is my 2 by pi, because I can written this function as f of x, sorry, phi of x is fx plus 2 over phi of this. So this is my lambda. So 1 minus lambda times of this minus lambda times of this 0, this is also 0, 1 minus lambda times of this. So minus minus plus pi by 2. X is right hand side. So this is my 0, 0, 0, 1 plus lambda is my 2 by pi. So this is my 2. Fine. Now it's non-homogeneous. What is the right hand side is? Limit is my from 0 to pi, G1. G1 is my here of fx. Second is G2. G2 is my sine and fx. Okay, so this is f of t, you can see f of t r here. Now, what is the option? Infinitely many solution. What is the rank of the A? 1. When it has a infinite many solution, when it has also the rank 1, then only it has the infinite many solutions, because they must be equal. So when it will be the rank of 1? When this value, when both the values are 0, or you can say when this value must be 0. Simple rule is there, because when this value is a non-zero, then the rank of this will be 2. But we need this value must be 0. Fine. So again, when it will be 0, we can use the orthogonal property, because once it's a cos square, answer is pi by 2, it's a non-zero. So what is the orthogonal property? This is equal to non-zero only when f is cos. So this option is cancelled out. This cos t is cos 3, and all of you know that cos of nx into cos of mx is 0 if n is not equal to m. So this is the option right answer. Sine and cosine by the orthogonal property is a 0. This is also the 0. So the right answer is B, C and D are my correct answers. Okay, again you can see this one. So what is the F1? G1. Cos x, cos, I can written xi as a say t, f2 minus sin x, f2 sorry, g2 is sine of xi. Now the limits are from 0 to pi. What is the alpha? 1, 1. 0 to pi, cos square, so it is pi by 2. 1, 2, orthogonal property, cos and sine will be 0. 2, 1, cos and sine orthogonal property 0. 2, 2, sine square, it's a minus pi by 2. So I can return as a matrix. 1 minus lambda is not given to you. So lambda times pi by 2, 0, 0, 1 plus lambda pi, 0. Because it's a non-homogeneous, so we can return also the right hand side. 0 to pi, f1 is cos into cos, that's a cos square. And from the right hand side is a sine, g2 into cos, it's a cos and sine. Again, by using the orthogonal property, this is my pi by 2, this is my 0. I can substitute here. Now we can check about the proper options. So what is the option? Unique solution when lambda is equal to 1. So what will happen if lambda is equal to 1? So what is the rank of A? It is 2. If once the rank of A is 2, rank of A by B is also the 2. So once both are same and is equal to same, this one, second part is also be there. So it's a unique solution, yes. It's a unique solution, yes. But if lambda is equal to 2 by pi, what will happen? This value will be, when lambda is equal to 2 by pi, this is 0, 0, 0, and this value is my 2. So the rank of A is 2, and rank of A by B is also 2. So does it give an infinite many solution? No. Infinite many solution only when it is not equal to 2. The first option is cancelled. Lambda is equal to minus 1, it's a unique solution. When lambda is equal to minus 1, this value is my non-zero. This is non-zero, this is non-zero. So what is the, when lambda is equal to minus 1, what is the rank of A? This is my 2. Rank of A condition B is also my 2. So it's a unique solution, yes. Infinite many solution when lambda is minus 2 by pi. So we can see, when lambda is my minus 2 over pi, what is that? This is a non-zero. This is 0, this is 0, this is 0. Rank of A is my 1. So what will happen? The matrix will be non-zero, 0, 0, 0. And the right hand side is here. What is the rank of A condition B? Rank of A condition B is also 1 because of this 0. So what is the meaning of that infinite many solutions? Unique solution when lambda is not equal to 2 by pi. So when lambda is not equal to 2 by pi, this value will be a 0. This value will be a non-zero. So the rank of them is a 1, which will not give you a unique solution. No solution when plus minus of this. So when it will be the no solution? You can see, when lambda is equal to 2 by pi, rank of this is 2, rank of this is, both are same. So definitely it will be an infinite many solution. So the right answer is only B is my correct answer. Okay. Look at this one. So firstly, I can find the value of the phi x, simplify. I can multiply by 2. It's a 2x square plus 2 times ex e raised to power minus y phi y dy. Fine. So now you can see f1, g1. G1 is with respect to y. F1 is here. So what is the alpha? 1, 1. This into this, e raised to power 0 of y, that is 1. This is my lambda. So what is that? It's a non-homogeneous. So we can write, it's a 1 cross 1. So a will be my 1 minus lambda times 1, 1, 1. Is a 1. Lambda is my 2. So it is minus 1. So my system will be minus 1x. Right hand side is 0 to 1 g into fx or f of t. So what is the answer of this? 1 to 0 e raised to power minus of t square. Now how you can integrate them? Again, the simple shortcut tricks for you. So you can take the derivative until it becomes a 0. Here you can take the derivative. You can take the derivative. You can take the derivative. Now, what you can do, you can multiply this as a plus. You can multiply this as a minus. You can multiply this as a plus. So what is the integration on this side? Left hand side is my minus of x. This integration will be t square e raised to power minus of t minus 2t e raised to power minus of t minus 2 e raised to power minus of t from 1 to 0. So you can see that When it is a 1, so answer is minus e raised to power minus 1, minus 2 e raised to power minus 1, 2 e raised to power minus 1. When it is a 0, this value will be 0, this value will be 0, this value will be plus of 2. So what is the answer? 2 minus 5 e raised to power minus 1. It's a minus of x. So what is the x is my there? 5 e raised to power minus 1 minus of 2. So which now you have to find the phi of 0. So you can see which one is the multiple of the 5 e raised to power minus 1. You can see here. I can return this number as of. So the right answer is my here. This number can never be written in this form, this form, this form. So right answer is my A on. Okay. Now again, I can return as a sine of A plus B, sine A, cos B, and F2 cos A, sine B. Fine. So this is the simple procedure about that. Now, what you can do, you can find the value of the alpha 1 1. What is the alpha 1 1? G1, that's a sine and cosine 0 because of the orthogonal property. 1 2, this is a cos square. Orthogonal property is my pi by 2. 2 1, sine and sine square. Orthogonal property pi by 2 because limit is my 0 to pi. G2 F2, cos and sine. So it is my 0. So system will be lambda is my here. 1 minus lambda times 0. Minus lambda times pi by 2, lambda times pi by 2, 1 minus lambda times 0. Ax, because it's a homogeneous, so right hand side is 0. So what is the answer of this? 1 minus lambda times pi by 2, minus lambda times pi by 2, and 1. So when it will have a solution? When the determinant of this is a non-zero. A very simple task. So that means 1 lambda square, pi square by 4 is a 0. Okay, now you can find the value of lambda is, that's a 2 by pi minus 2 by pi. Fine. Now another shortcut trick is how you can find the value of the y. That's a very simple target for you here. That's a times f1 plus b times f2. Fine. So what is that? You can see, what is the f1? Sine x. A sine x. What is the f2? Cos x. B cos x. Fine. Now you can substitute the value when lambda is 2 by pi. So it is my 2 by pi. What is the a and b? Now see here, when lambda is my 2 by pi. Fine. So this number is my, it's a 2 cross 2 matrix. So what is the a? 1. It is a 2 by pi. It's my minus 1. It's my minus 1. It's a plus 1. So what is the rank of this? You can add them. What is the meaning of that? Minus 1, 0, 0. So what is the meaning of that? If I multiply them, it has dimension 1 only. Or you can say, if I say C1 and C2, or X1 and X2 are there. So it means X1 minus X2 is a 0. So you can see the sum of the coefficients is my 0. So the coefficient when lambda is 2 by pi here. So X1 minus X2 is equal to 0. That means X1 is equal to X2. That's the constants are same. So these are both are same. You can see both are same. This option can, but this is a minus. It is a cancel out. Look at the second option. If I just clear this screen for you. If I take lambda is my minus 2 by pi. What is the a? 1. It's a plus 1. It is plus 1. It's a plus 1. Again, you can see if you reduce them, it's here. So what is the meaning of that? If I say x1 and x2, x1 plus x2 is a 0, or means x1 is equal to minus of x2. That's the constants are my here. You can see this a constant is my a plus b, but a plus b is non-zero. Right answer is my here. So c and d are my correct answers. Okay, next one is there. Now you can see here, this is the homogeneous. What is the homogeneous equation is? Lambda times limit is my from 0 to 1 kernel and phi of t dt. Fine. Now here this is a limit of the x, but we need a limit of the t. So I can change, replace here. A simple rule for that. Now I can change the limit from 0 to x and from x to 1. Clear? So I can return this as here. Now what you can do, I can substitute the value here from 0 to x, t plus 1 times x phi of t plus lambda is a common, I can take as from x to 1 x plus 1 of t phi t. Now they are not asking about the solution, they are talking about the eigenvalue. We can take the derivative. What is the phi dash? Partial derivative this with respect to x, it is my t plus 1 phi of t plus upper limit x plus 1 phi of x. Now you can take this part. What is that? Partial derivative of x is my t phi of t minus x plus 1 x phi of x. These values are cancelled out. Again take the second derivative. It's a 0, so you can take the upper value as x plus 1 phi of x plus partial derivative is a 0, upper limit is this, so 0 minus x phi of x. Now if you open this bracket, what will happen? It's a lambda times, so lambda is a common for all case, x phi x will be cancelled out, so lambda times phi, phi double dash is here. So what is the meaning of that? Phi double dash minus of here. Fine. Now we can find the solution. So we can take the option when lambda is 1. So the solution will be is a 1, so plus minus e raised to power x plus c2 e raised to power minus x. What is the condition? You can see what is the phi of 0. If I say this is the phi of x, 0. So here 0 if 0 is a 0, 0 of 1, this is a 0. What is the phi dash of 0? So what is the phi dash of 0? So phi dash is my here, 0 to 0 is 0, 0 to 1 is a constant value. So here, so you can see both the values are same. So what is the phi of 0 is 0? What is the meaning of that? C1 plus C2 is my, sorry, what is that? This is, no, it's not a 0. It's a 0 to 1, 0 to 1 t phi t. And here is again, so phi of 0, I can rub for you here. Phi of 0 is phi dash of 0. So what is that? If I say this is the phi, so c1 plus c2, what is the derivative? Is c1 minus c2. So we can see c2 will be a 0. So the solution will be e raised to power x. That's a correct answer. Look at the other options, how you can do the other options. So we can see if I take lambda is my minus n square, it's a common form. So what is that solution of this? So phi will be my c1 cos nx, c2 sin nx. Again, we can take phi of 0 is phi dash 0. What will happen? C1 sin will be a 0 plus c2 n cos is my 1. This is a derivative. What is the phi of 0? Phi of 0 is my cos 0 1, sin 0 is a 0. So what is that? C1 will be cancelled out. So C1 is equal to n times C2. Again, you can see, check phi double dash. Here you can see that once you will solve, you will get C2 as my n pi. Fine. Now, which of the correct option is my here? So y C1 is n times of pi 2. So you can simply, there is no need of this. So I can substitute value here. C1 is n times C2. So n cos n pi plus sine of C2. That's my right answer of this problem. Now you can check that. When it is of this, so n will be my pi. So it's a pi cos n pi. Pi cos n pi sine. So this is the right answer. What is the n? If you compare them, it can be written as 2 pi square. So n is my 2, but this is not a 2. This is the n, this is a 2 pi x. That's a 2 pi, that's my 2 pi x. It's a, now this is not the correct answer. So first a and d are my correct answers. These are similar of this. Again, this is a similar case of this. You can, once you will solve this, you can see if I start from the phi, again the homogeneous is there. You can break them from 0 to x. This is t of x minus 1. And then from x to 1, टी टाइम्स सॉरी एक्स एंड टी माइनस वन ऑफ दिस. सो दिस इज सिमिलर ऑफ दिस प्रीवियस वन आर देयर. सो वंस हियर यू कैन सिंपलीफाई दिस. इफ यू लुक अबाउट द ऑप्शंस, व्हाट इज द ऑप्शन इज देयर, दिस अ सिंपल, देर आर द सिंपल ऑप्शंस आर देयर. सो यू कैन सी वंस यू विल सॉल्व अगेन यू विल गेट दिस एज द हियर. नाउ व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ दैट. इफ आई टेक एन स्क्वायर, लैम्डा इज माई माइनस एन स्क्वायर, सो व्हाट इज माई फाई, सी वन कोस एन एक्स प्लस सी टू साइन एन एक्स. नाउ व्हाट यू कैन डू, यू कैन सिंपली टेक, यू कैन सिंप्लीफाई दिस वेरी वेरी सिंपल. फाई डैश जीरो हियर, सो वन फाई ऑफ जीरो, फाई ऑफ जीरो सी वन, फाई डैश जीरो इज अ साइन कोस, इट कैंसल आउट, इज एन सी टू एन सी टू कोस, कोस इज माई वन, सो सी वन इज हियर. इफ यू टेक फाई ऑफ जीरो इज फाई डबल डैश जीरो, सो वट इज द फाई जीरो इज हियर. वट इज द सेकेंड डेरिवेटिव, साइन इज कोस, कोस इज अगेन साइन, सो एन सी वन एंड इट इज माई हियर, सो जीरो. इट मीन्स सी वन विल बी माई जीरो. सो वन सी वन विल बी जीरो, ऑल आर माई साइन फॉर्म. सो सोल्यूशन विल बी सी टू साइन एन एक्स. नाउ यू कैन सी हियर लैम्डा इज माइनस एन स्केयर, सो एन इज माई पाई साइन पाई एक्स सेटिस्फाइड. हियर एन इज माई रूट टू, रूट टू पाई इट्स अ टू पाई कैंसल आउट, रूट थ्री कैंसल आउट. वट इज द एन, इफ यू कंपेयर दैम एन इज माई टू पाई, सो एन इज माई हियर. करेक्ट आंसर इज वन एंड फोर आर माई करेक्ट ऑप्शन. ओके सो अगेन दिस इज माई एफ वन जी वन. ओके द थिंग इज सॉल्व. ओके यू कैन सी लुक एट दैट, द इंटीग्रल इक्वेशन हैज़ अ यूनिक सोल्यूशन. सो दिस इज ए एक्स इज इक्वल टू बी वेन इट हैज़ अ यूनिक सोल्यूशन. ओके वेन डिटर्मिनेंट ऑफ सॉरी वेन रैंक ऑफ ए, रैंक ऑफ ए बाई बी इज सेम एज टू बिकॉज देर आर द टू वेरिएबल्स. द गिवन इक्वेशन हैज़ अ यूनिक सोल्यूशन इफ लैम्डा इज नॉट द करेक्टरिस्टिक्स नंबर. दैट्स करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट बिकॉज वंस यू नो यू कैन राइट दिस नंबर एज ऑफ दिस. इफ लैम्डा इज द करेक्टरिस्टिक्स नंबर, वट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ दैट. द डिटर्मिनेंट ऑफ ए इज जीरो. वंस डिटर्मिनेंट ऑफ ए जीरो, सो रैंक इज नॉट इक्वल टू टू. Once rank is not equal to 2, you can never get a unique solution. So it means this is the correct answer. The integral equation has a solution. Ax is equal to b has a solution. Then, what is that? G1f, that is my b. G2f, that's my b. Both are 0. They said it has a solution. That is not a correct statement. This system, because they are talking about the solution, not for the unique solution. This has a solution when rank of a by b is less than of the 2. That's a infinite many solution. So this statement is false. So both as false, as 2 is true, as 1 is a false, is the right answer. This is a similar of this. You can see f1 g1 f2 g2. This is my cos x cos t minus 2 sin x sin of t. So what is the alpha 1 1? Orthogonal property 0 to pi, pi by 2. Alpha 1 2 cos and sin 0. Alpha 2 1 sin and cos orthogonal 0. Alpha 2 2 sin minus of 2 sin square. So it's a minus of 2 pi by 2. So it's a minus of pi. Fine. So you can write as a matrix A. 1 minus lambda is not given to you, that's a pi by 2, 0, 0, 1 plus of this. What is the right hand side is 0 to pi cos 7x. So g1 cos 0 sin 0. Fine. Now how you can solve that? That's a very simple. You can find lambda is not given to you. So how you can solve this? If you find the determinant of this, so this will be my 2 upon pi. And this is minus 1 over pi. Fine. So now you can check that. When lambda is 2 by 5, find the rank of the A. Matrix A will be 0, 0, 0, 3. Rank of A is my 3. Fine. Rank of A by B is also 3. Sorry, 2. So it has a unique solution. So if I simply say C1 and C2 or X1 and X2 is 0, what is the meaning of that? X2 will be 0. So you have to find this solution. Solution is lambda times AF1 BF2, lambda is 2 upon pi, first case, F1 is cos, and here x2, that's the second component, that's a b is my 0, so this is my a cos x, so that give you a solution. For every lambda, solution exists. There exists a lambda such that solution does not exist, so there is no exist. So when the solution does not exist, there exists a lambda, but there exists certain lambda, because the solution does not exist for only these two cases. When I take a is lambda is minus half, so it will be, is what is the answer of this? It will be, when it is minus half, minus 1 by pi, it's a 3 by 2, 0, 0, 0. Still it has a solution, because rank of a is 1, which is same as that of the rank of a by b. It means it has infinite many solution, but still it is higher. There exists a lambda such that there are more than one, but finitely many, but we get an infinite many. The second law. There exists a lambda such that there are infinite many solutions. That is, this is a lambda for which infinite many solutions. So the right answer is A and D are my correct answers. This is the similar of this. This is the similar question of the previous one. Once you will solve that, you can simplify this. You will get the equation like of here. Fine. So now you can consider the case. This will be your n minus n square. So phi will be your c1 cos nx, c2 sine of nx. Fine. Now it is say minus r. Okay. So now you can simplify. That's a very simple one. So you will try to solve this is my n. Fine. It will be given as a cos of here. It will be given like this way. So once you will try to solve this, that's a very that's a simple usual calculation. Once you do the calculation, you will get an answer as of this, because it will give you like of this. It will be cos of x is a 0. When it will be 0? When it will be 2n plus 1 pi by 2 here. So pi will be cancelled out. So 2n plus 1 over 2 is my this. Can you find the value of this? 2n plus 1 over square minus 1. So this is the right answer. Okay, look at the last question. So again, we can write this as f1, f2, g1, g2. So this is cos x, cos a, cos b, sine a, sine b. Limits are from 0 to pi. Again, we are using the orthogonal properties of the integration. Cos square 0 to pi by 2 cos square, so limit is half of this, it is pi by 4. 1 2, cos and sine, now it is not a 0. Why? Because it's a cos sine, so it is my sine of 2x, because the limit is now my 0 to pi by 2, it's my minus cos 2x over 2. From 0 to pi by 2 is my minus 1 by 2, 0 is my minus 1, so it's a minus of 1. What is the alpha of 2,1? Alpha of 2,1 will be my, what is the alpha of 2,1? 2,1. Sorry, it's a divided by 2 also, so it's a half. Again, this will give you half, and 2,2, because of the symmetricness, you can easily see it's a pi by 4. So what is the matrix? Lambda times pi by 4, lambda times 2, half of this. This is my a x. Right hand side is my g1 f1. So what is the integration of the 0 to pi by 2? Cos of t, that's a 1. Integration of the g2 pi by 2, it's again a 1. Now what is the right answer? Now you can check that. Now you can solve this unique solution. So when the determinant is a non-zero. So you can see 1 minus lambda pi by 4 square minus minus plus of this. You can see, I can see a plus b, a minus b. So it will give you minus pi by 4, pi plus 2, and 1 minus 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 plus 2 minus pi by 4. So what is the meaning of that? This will give you here. And second value will be 4 over pi minus 2. So both the values when the lambda is non equal to this, then you will get as a unique solution. The first one is only give you this answer. Both answer must be there. Now the rest part is that you have to find the rank. So I can find this value for the rank. So what you can do, that's again a very simple, when lambda is equal to this, what is this matrix? What is that? It's a pi by 4. What is the lambda times pi by 4? So 4 upon pi plus 2 into pi by 4. 4 will be cancelled out. So pi by 2 upon pi plus 2. So this value will be 2 upon pi plus 2. This value will be minus 2 upon pi plus 2. This value will be minus 2 upon pi plus 2. This value will be 2 upon pi plus 2. This is 1, 1. Now you can see if you simply add them, this value will be 0, 0. This value will be 2. Rank of A is my 1. Rank of A by B is my 2. So that means no solution. Lambda is equal to this is no solution, correct. But the corresponding homogeneous solution has a non-trivial solution. What is the homogeneous system is here? When it will be the non-trivial solution? When determinant of A is a 0. And you can see the rank of A is 1, which is less than of 2. So it has a infinite many solution. That's a non-trivial solution. That's the correct statement. When lambda is equal to pi times pi by 4. So what will happen if I write for you here? When lambda is 4 upon pi minus 2. So what is the value of this? What is the answer of this? This will be give you a minus 2 upon pi minus 2. Minus lambda by 2 is minus times pi minus 2. It is minus 2 times pi minus 2. And this is minus 2 times pi minus 2. This right hand side is 1, 1. If you simply subtract them, R2 minus R1, 0, 0. Rank of A is same as rank of A by B, but is less than of the 2. It gives you infinite many solution, but they are talking about no solution. So right answer is my C on. So this is the way you can solve all these previous year questions in a very simple shortcut tricks about. So I hope you can learn this concept. We will see the next lecture on the ordinary differential equations with the help of the very simple tricks, same as such. You can simply follow, like and share my videos. Best of luck, students. Thank you.